Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I'm glad to be here.
Amen.
And I thank God for all the blessings that we have been receiving during these last days. And I brought also greetings from Curacao, from the church down there, and also greeting from the churches in South America, in Brazil, and Argentina, and Uruguay. And the work is doing a wonderful work in South America. And we are working back and forth with the people there in South America for almost 5 years. I was moving back and forth from Curaçao to Brazil. I took one time Morgan with me, and we are working back and forth, and Pastor Allen also. And the church is growing there in South America. And one of these days, I will give some testimony and show some pictures of the work going on in South America. And there is a great need in South America for our young people, because many of those families that are coming now to the truth about God, they don't have a school for their children to go. And they have to send them to schools that they went to the school, non-Trinitarian, and then when they come out Trinitarian and fighting with the father and the mothers. And they say this is our great need, to have a school that our children can go and learn how to be medical missionaries, how to be missionaries preaching the word of God all over in South America and all over in the world. And we have to keep this in prayer, that God will open the way, and also young people and young adults that would like to go and do the work, we need them there in South America. Only in Brazil there are more than 200 million people. And God is working on the hearts of the people, bringing them, preparing them for the soon coming of Jesus Christ. Back in 1991, I studied preventive healthcare in Desert Hot Spring Therapy Center with Dr. Charles Thomas. And since that time, I was been sharing in all the states of California, and then in Europe, in Germany, Belgium, Holland, and now in South America, the 10 principles of health. Very important. And Weimar Institute, they study these principles, and they come up with a word, with the name, New Start. You know, they put a New Start, 8 principles, but there are 10. But for you, easy to remember them, New Start, you already have 8. You know, nutrition, exercise, water, air,
Sunshine.
Temperance.
Rest.
Fresh air.
Rest.
Trust in divine power.
And there is 2 more. Yeah. There is 2 more. It is correct
posture.
And proper dress. Don't forget them. We have 10 fingers. We can remember them. New start, you have the 8, and then with 2 more, then you have 10 principles. And according to Isaiah 58 verse 1, we have to be sure that we don't transgress God's principles, God's law. Because the transgression of law is sin. If we transgress these 10 principles of health, then we will have the consequences with our health. And therefore, Isaiah 58 gives his counsel to obey the health's principles. And tonight I'm going to talk a little bit on nutrition, which is the first one, nutrition. And it is very important for us to know what is going on in our world today about nutrition. After I study preventive healthcare, sharing these principles with the people, I see every time the necessity to study more also in agriculture. And Sister White says, the E, B, and C of education is agriculture. Do you think that agriculture and nutrition is important? Yeah, very important. When we work with sick people, people who have different health issues, we see that the nutrition is very important. And do you know today, many people try to eat healthy, to eat good food. But is it easy to find good food today? Do you know that 25% of all the soybeans on this world is manipulated? GMOs? Studying about this manipulation and GMOs and mixing seeds, mingling of seeds, Leviticus 19:19, that God tells us don't mingle different kinds of seeds, even animals, because it have consequences. And the consequence is that it brings confusion to the brain. GMOs fruit bring, and vegetables bring confusion to the mind. And you remember that God wants to seal us. God wants us to be established in the truth, and we need to have a frontal lobe that functions properly. We need to have a well-balanced mind. And then, therefore, nutrition is very important in these 10 principles. For example, studying this problem of GMOs, do you know that many fruits, vegetables that we have on our table today, are eating them, are manipulated, or hybrid? You can imagine, when I study this and I investigate these things, I was shocked. How many fruits and vegetables today that people have on their table has been manipulated, have been violated, because God says in Leviticus 19:19, don't mingle seeds. And do you know, when I was in Germany, we made some studies about genes, and people come up with a lot of scientific studies to show that health problems today basically is in the genes. And it has to do with our nutrition. When you really make some investigation on nutrition today and all this business of GMOs, you will come to see and understand that many health problems have to do with what we eat. There are some fruits and vegetables that even exist before men have. And studies show that these GMOs fruits, what they do, that they cause problems when in the genes they have to give information one to another. It causes confusion. And this is the big problem today with cancer, diabetic, high blood pressure, you can name them, all the problems of health that we have. And therefore, when I was studying this problem of GMOs, and I come to see many fruits and vegetables that in the past I thought that was fruit and vegetables that God has made, I come to the conclusion that God didn't make these things. And many people, they don't know. They sit down, them, they eat these things, and they cause problems. And also it says that when you change your diet, when you can have organic fruits and vegetables, you can see how your health will improve. And there are scientific studies that show this. And when God gives us some instructions, God gives us His law and statutes, if we obey them, we will be blessed. And Isaiah also says that our health will improve. Because it is the violation of these principles, of these laws and regulations that God gave, bring upon us these consequences of disease and especially cancer. And many people are involved in health issues today. I have been helping many people all over, in South America, in Germany. People like to have something to just take in and the problem is gone. But with these 10 principles, we see that we have to change our lifestyle. And therefore, these 10 principles, we have to have good nutrition, exercise, water, sunlight, temperance, air, rest, trust in God, correct posture, and proper dress. If we are in harmony with these 10 simple principles that we can have on our fingers, maybe you are living today, you think that you are healthy, but maybe you have cancer. You don't know. But if you change your lifestyle today, you can reverse that cancer. And as soon as you know about this principle, start practicing them immediately. Because scientifically it's proved that many people who had cancer, who had many health problems, when they practice these simple 10 principles, their problem reversed. They were on the way in cancer and they reversed. And some people have been completely healed by these simple principles, changing your lifestyle, especially your diet. And when you have a good diet, good nutrition, and then exercise is very important. You know, when the blood have all his vitamins, minerals, protein, then the blood have to be circulating and visiting all the organs, you know, of the body. This is very important. Nutrition and exercise. But this problem of GMOs is not in our hand, everybody's hand to control. If you want to escape, if you want to have food that are not GMOs, then you have to need to do some agriculture. Because it is difficult today to find food that are not GMO food. And therefore, God have given Sister White knowledge. And she says in the book of Ministry of Healing, every family his own house or home on the land. Sufficient land around his home so that his life could be a life of labor and independent. He says, no human device have improved this plan. And if you study God's plan for Israel, was that every family have a piece of land, sufficient land to do agriculture. Because your health depends on agriculture. Recently, back in Kyrgyzstan, we have a big problem with agriculture because we have been importing a lot of fruits and vegetables from Venezuela. And Venezuela today is in a big crisis, health and food crisis. And then the Minister of Health decided to make an investigation because a lot of people, they notice they are obese or others are below their normal weight. And they make a scientific investigation. And to make a long story short, the investigation showed it is because of the agriculture. Because the people don't get food that really nourish the body. And they are doing efforts to teach more people how to raise up their own fruits and vegetables. And I have been called to give a class on teaching agriculture, and I teach moral agriculture. Did you hear about that in the past, moral agriculture? And many people, when I teach moral agriculture, they ask me, they don't know what the word moral means. There is moral agriculture and immoral agriculture. And I start always with my class, my teaching, with the seed. There is the problem. There is the root of the problem, the seed. It is the GMO seeds that cause this problem. And I have to start at 9:30. Let's stop at 9:30. Yeah. Yeah, okay, just 1 minute. It is important that we have good seeds, because it is the seed. There is the root of the problem today with our nutrition. We need to be sure that we have organic seed, that seed has not been manipulated. And then we can change many problems, health issues. Therefore, the Lord says in Leviticus 19:19, be sure that we don't transgress God's law in manipulating with the seed, because it changed the character of the plant and changed the character of the fruits, the beans and everything. And this caused problem with our genes. Tomorrow we will continue with exercise. May God bless us, and if we obey God's principles, we can be sure that God will bless us and that our health will improve. This is my prayer. Amen. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Okay, we will continue with our health message and new start. And every night we will repeat it. There are 10. You know, it will help us if we remember the word new start. We already have 8. Then the first one is?
Nutrition. Exercise, water, sunlight, temperance, air, rest, trust in God, power, posture, and dress.
Okay, very good. Good students. Okay, and tonight we will continue. Last night we did water exercise, and tonight we will continue with sunlight and temperance. Sunlight and temperance. Sunlight, it kills germs and provides vitamin D for strong bones and muscles. There would be no life without sunshine. How important is the sun? It puts color in plants and give your rosy cheeks. And today we see how important sunshine is. Many people are using also as a solar system all over the world, and especially if you see agriculture, if there is no sun, there will be no food.
That's right.
Because we cannot live on solar energy just as it comes to us, but we need the plants. And the plants take the solar energy, and he gives us protein, carbohydrate, vitamins, so that we can eat it. That's a blessing. And then we move forward with the word temperance. It says a strong person will say no to things which harm his body. Tobacco, drugs, alcohol, food with lots of sugar or fat, or even too much food will make us weak and sick. There's temperance. One of the examples in the Bible, especially for the youth, is the book of Daniel. Daniel was temperate, and God blessed him. God gave them wisdom. God gave them visions and dreams. And today, our youth also can be Daniels if they are temperate. In the book of Minister of Healing, I'm going to read Minister of Healing, chapter 11, on page 129. Minister of Healing, chapter 11, page 129. It says, working for the intemperate. It says, deliver them that are carried away into death, and those that are ready to be slain, see that thou hold back. And it's continued to say, every true reform has its place in the work of the gospel and tends to the uplifting of the soul to a new and nobler life. Especially thus, the temperance reform demand the support of Christian workers. They should call attention to this work and make it a living issue. Everywhere there should be present to the people the principles of the true temperance and call for sickness to the temperance pledge. Earnest effort should be made in behalf of those who are in bondage to evil habits. One of the big problems that we see today, especially in youth, the problem of temperance that lead them in evil habits. Do you know the development of the communication system? Today, everybody have these
cell phones,
computers, those electric devices. And do you know that many people, many young people are being practicing evil habits with these things? Even adults have problems with these electronic devices. Mm-hmm. And many families is in problem because of these electronic devices. Children are not temperate. They don't know how to use these things. They spend the whole night on these things. And we just have an experience with a young boy of 12 years, 30 years. And he tells us, life is electronics. At school, he don't like to study. He don't take care of his body. They have to tell them to go to take a shower. He smelled bad only on this telephone computer all the day long. Evil habits. And this is a big problem. We have to pray about it, and we have to ask God to help us, to help the young people, how to be temperance in using these electronic devices. Not only the youth, but you see also adults who is in this problem. They are not temperate in using these electronic devices. And then it will affect the people. And today, many, many people are in big problems. Just as people who use drugs, they cannot put aside these electronics. May God help us to be temperate in temperance in everything.
Amen.
Not to use it too much. Just use it as a as a tool,
yes.
Not as a thing that you have to be all the day long on that thing. You remember days ago, I read a history of a lady. She was in a hotel, and she was walking with his telephone, then she fall in the swimming pool. And then the man that was just working for the hotel saw her, and he put it on the Facebook. And the lady was so angry, and he talked with the owner of the hotel, and the man would lose his job. And many times, I'm walking in the city, I have to just step on because people are just walking and doing this. And this is a big problem today. We have to pray that God will help us so that we can spend more time with our Bible.
Amen.
Than these electronic devices. Yeah. May God bless us, and that we can be like Daniel, so we can have also the experience that Daniel had, visions and dreams by God. May God bless us. Okay, good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
We will continue with our health class. And today, before we move in these 10 principles, I have a question for the class. And I will give you two Bible verses which help you to give an answer to this question that I'm gonna make. It is multiple choice, you can say yes or no. Isaiah chapter 58, verse 1. Isaiah chapter 58, verse 1. It says, cry loud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgression, and the house of Jacob their sins. We have been talking about the new start. The first letter was nutrition. Okay. The question is this. Think about it. Can we eat a tangelo?
Pardon me?
A tangelo.
What is that?
A fruit. You have it here?
No.
Sure. No. You have a tangerine?
Yes.
Mandarin?
Yeah.
Okay. In biology, it shows you that... Tangelo?
Yeah, tangelo.
That tangelo, where it come from? And I just want to make this question.
It's a crossbreed.
Yes. So, this fruit is a fruit that has been crossed. Grapefruit and tangerine. So, according to Isaiah 58, verse 1, and according to Leviticus 19:19, it is...
No.
Yeah. And then if we use... our intelligence when we eat. We don't eat because the fruit is sweet or before what they put on our table, it is sweet. It tastes good. We don't eat with our taste buds, but we eat with our
mind.
What is good, what is healthy.
That is very important. In the physiology, anatomy, and histology of the brain, we have to use always our intelligence when we eat. And so many fruits and vegetables today have been crossed. And sometimes we eat them because we don't know we eat them. And therefore, before we eat, if we don't know what it is, exactly what it is, just pray to God to protect us. But if we have the knowledge what it is, then we have to. And that is temperance. Avoid everything that is harmful for our body.
Amen.
So then when we sit on the table, when we're going to eat something, always think, use our brain, our mind, and think about it. What kind of vitamins I'm going to receive? What kind of minerals my body going to receive if I eat this? And sometimes I have some good friends back in Curacao, and I see them smoking, and sometimes I say, what kind of vitamins you know? And they start thinking, you know? And it is important, these points, that we don't just eat because our taste buds are telling us it is good, it smells good, it's, just eat it. No, we have to pray to God to be temperance in everything, and temperance is avoid everything that is harmful for our body.
And eat moderate.
And eat moderate, sure. Exactly. Not because it is good, it is, I like it, I keep eating it. So, today we will continue with the eight principles, and we move forward with air and rest today, and tomorrow we will finish trust in God, correct posture and proper dress. Air. Fresh, pure air, both day and night, give us oxygen and purified our blood. Open the windows often and spend a lot of time outside. Stay away from smoke and fumes. Very important. If we can sleep with our windows open during the night, it's the best thing. We will get a lot of oxygen. And we have also to have the habit, that deep breath, you know? Take deep by the nose and fill our lungs so that our blood can be well oxygenated and to circulate and visit all the organs so that they can function properly. Very important, this point. And rest. Early to bed and early to rise will keep us healthy and wise. Everybody wants to be wise. Yeah, we don't like to. Try to go to bed at the time you like to go. If it is 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, don't worry. If you want to go, just go back where you want. No, it says try to go to bed all the same time each day.
Yes.
Are we going to bed every time, every night, it's the same time?
We should.
We need to be temperance in rest. Why? Sister White says that we have to turn out the lights 9:30. Turn out the lights. Turn off the lights. And go to? Why? Yeah, the 2 hours of sleep before midnight have more value than 4 hours after midnight. And we don't have time to go into all the scientific investigation that they made about sleeping. And your room have to be
dark.
Dark. If you want to have a good devotional study in the morning, we have to go to bed
early,
so that we can wake up early. And she says, go to bed at the same time. And then we will form this habit that we don't need to use any telephone or anything to wake us up in the morning. The mind will be so having this good habit that at 4 o'clock, you wake up and study and prayer. This is very important. I have this habit. 4 o'clock, I wake up in the morning, every day 4 o'clock, no matter where I am. I study from 4 o'clock to 6, and then from 6 to 8, I do gardening. And this is a great blessing. And at 9 o'clock, I go to bed. Everywhere where I go, 9 o'clock, or even 8:30, I go to bed. And this is a blessing.
Yes, it is.
Every night, try to go But we know that when you travel or when you do some work for the Lord, you can be all the time, you know, have this schedule. But if you are at home, form the habit to go to bed every night at the same hour, and God will bless us.
When should we get up?
If you have, it depends, an adult, you need 7 or 8 hours, some need less, but 7 or 8 hours is okay for you. So that when you go back, you go to bed at 9 o'clock or 8:30, then at 4:30 you are ready to go. And the body will, you will just wake up. You don't need to have a telephone, because you know, if we sleep with this advice to wake us up, it will wake you up, but when you come up like in stress, you have to just wake up when your body get the enough rest. Otherwise, you wake up with stress. You know, it just like shaking you to come out of the sleep. And therefore, it is important for us to go at the same time and wake up at a time early in the morning, so that God can bless us. And I'm sure God can use us as his instrument to help others to form these good habits. May God bless us as we continue.
Amen.
Study the 8 principles of health, or 10 principles of health. And they are simple, but they work.
Yes.
God used simple methods,
Amen.
But it worked. And we have to have faith in these simple methods. May God bless us. So, good evening.
Good evening.
This is our last class, our health class, Isaiah 58, verse 8. We're going to read Isaiah 58, verse 8. And this is my prayer for each one of us. Then shall thy light break forth as the morning, and thy health shall spring forth speedily. And thy righteousness shall go forth before thee, the glory of the Lord shall be thy reward. We're going to finish our 8 laws, or principles, or remedies, some other people call them the 8 doctors. And I promise you that we will add 2 more, make it 10 on our fingers. So today we will finish with new start. The last letter, new start, is letter T. And that is?
Trust.
It says, God loves us and wants us to have peace in our hearts. Have peace in our heart. He will help you if you ask him to. Being thankful, forgiving, and cheerful. This is the best medicine. These are the best medicine. If we study these 8 principles in harmony with the anatomy and physiology of the body, we understand how God gives us these principles and how important they are for our health. I'm going to quickly go into a little bit anatomy and physiology of the brain. And I'm going to show you how important these 8 principles, 8 remedies, 8 doctors are in help us to have peace. And where do we have peace? In our digestive system? In our lungs? In our kidneys? In our skin? In our liver? No. Peace, it is in the brain. And these organs that I mentioned, in anatomy and physiology, it shows us that these organs are support system of the brain. Do you know? the brain cannot function without this support system. Digestive system, we have to have good nutrition so that the body can get his energy so that the brain can function properly. And also water, we have to drink enough water. Our kidneys need water to function, so to help our brain, this is the support system of the brain. And in anatomy and physiology, there is we have the name homeostasis. Homeostasis means standing the same, standing still. It means that the body is working in harmony to have homeostasis. And homeostasis is very important for good health. It says positive feedback in homeostasis is people die. So the body continually is working with this sustained system, these organs, to keep homeostasis so that the body can function and the brain can function properly. Very important, because it is the brain, it is in our frontal lobe, there we have our emotions, our feelings, reason, conscience, and will. And it is in the frontal lobe that our character is being formed. And it is the sustained, the organs of the body, the sustained system, help our frontal lobe to work properly, so that we can reach excellency. And all that we have been teaching and preaching and helping and giving counsels is to help our frontal lobe to take right decision. Music affects the frontal lobe. All that we have been teaching and preaching, we are don't have the intention to say nothing that people can feel that we are attacking, or we will tell you that don't eat this or don't eat that. The main thing is that we want you to have a frontal lobe that functions properly so that you can take right decisions. And therefore, it is important in the book of Revelation, chapter 22, verse 4. It says that God gonna seal us. We have been talking about sealing. And in verse 4 of Revelation 22, it shows us, the word says, and they shall see his face, and his name shall be in their forehead, their frontal lobe. So God wants our frontal lobe to function properly, helping us to take care of the body, be sure that there's good circulation, exercise, that the blood go through all the organs, that all the organs can work properly, sustaining the brain so that the frontal lobe can work properly, so that we can take decision to follow Jesus Christ, to obey the commandment. As Isaiah 58 verse 1 says, don't transgress God's commandment. Be in harmony with these simple principles, health, laws of health. And so we see that the organs, for example, the digestive system, as soon as, for example, someone take alcohol, you see that his character change. And there is many Seventh-day Adventists today that they have some brain power, mental problems, and they have to be on medications. And most of the time, because they are using this medication, they are depressed, they are under depression. And we have to pray to God for each one of us that we can obey these simple principles of health, and that God can bless our health, that our organs can function properly, so that the frontal lobe can reach the excellency so that God can put his name in our frontal lobe and be sealed and to see Jesus face to face when he comes. May God bless us as we study this beautiful message that God has for us. Isaiah 58 is a very important chapter in these last days because God gonna do great work when we obey his principles. May God bless us.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Let me ask a question.
Question? Pastor Allen, I don't know.
A couple.
Okay.
What's your, I think 58 talks about fasting.
Uh-huh. See? Yep.
Do you recommend that maybe once or twice a year, or is there a time to do it?
Well,
can you repeat the question?
Yes, brother is asking if we, Isaiah talk about fasting. If we can fast once or twice a year, is it good for our health to fast? And I say yes. And fasting is not only don't eat or don't drink, but our lifestyle, to be a vegetarian is a fasting. It's a lifestyle that we use our food in a way that we can call it a fast. But we can also go on a fast, just drink water, some juice, or go to a total fast, and that will help the body. Because something very important we have to understand, that the digestive system, if we can give it rest, just take one day of fasting and drink water, and it will help us. And be sure that our digestive system is clean. And I remember some years ago I took a class in biology, and the first thing the professor says, when you guys get a cold, just clean up the digestive tract, and you will get rid of cold. So important it is to keep those organs clean, and we can do the fasting and many other simple treatments.
Is there any harm in fasting?
It depends. It depends of also the health of the person. Some people who are diabetic, they have to take care. Others have some other problem. You have to take care how you fast.
Sure.
That is very important. Be careful in everything. And if you can get counsel from someone who have some knowledge about that, it's good to have advice before you go into that.
Yeah. Another
question. That's another question?
Thank you.
Okay. There's no more. Okay.
What is involved in histology? You mentioned that several times. You mentioned anatomy, physiology. What is histology?
It is histology, anatomy, and physiology. Histology is the chemical level of the body.
Okay.
Yeah, you go into more into genes and cells and the chemical system. And then coming to from the chemical system, you go to cell form tissues form organs, and organs together working form a system. And that is the system that support the brain. And therefore, it is important for us to we can separate health methods with agriculture, because our food comes from agriculture. And then from there, we see the chemicals that the enemy try to use chemicals to change the diet so that the what we eat, strange things will go into the circulation system of the blood, and then it go to the brain, and it affect the frontal lobe the way we think. And this is the scientific part of the health. Okay.
Did you talk about posture?
Oh, okay. I talk about two more principles, that is posture, correct posture, and proper dress. Correct posture is quickly. When we walk, we have to be sure that we walk straight. Our back, we have to walk straight, our feet, and try to be in a correct posture so that you can breathe better. If you walk like this, you can breathe better. You know, some people like walk like this, or like this, you know, and today our sisters, you know, some of them, you know, that's not correct posture, you know? And some have clothes that are too tight, and then when they breathe, then the diaphragm cannot move, and then also too tight, then when circulations go, the veins need space to move, to expand. But if we are too tight, then we have problems. Yes, and then also when we sit, try to sit always straight, you know, that you can breathe good. And don't sit in different way because you will have problems with your back. And also when you work in the garden, try not to put too much stress on your muscles of the back because otherwise you will have problem. And when you sleep also, some people sleep on their face. We have to sleep on our back, you know, just sleep, relax. And when you go to sleep, before you go, try to relax the body, because the whole day we are so tense, doing things there and there, and then we go to bed and sometimes we just sleep in stress like this, you know, and we can rest properly. Therefore, relax the body and try to have always the correct posture. And the other one, that is proper dress. Today we see that every time Satan tries to take more clothes from especially women. Yeah, we have to use clothes that cover, it depends also the weather that you are in, to cover our limbs, our extremities, and use also clothes that are not mingled, you know, cotton with other stuff. You be sure that you don't mix clothes. And then this is very important. And today, our world follow fashion. People don't think what these clothes can do to the body. And something very important, circulation. When you use clothes that you just expose too much of your body, then you change hemostasis. Our body, it functions on the temperature of 37 degrees Celsius. When you use less clothes, then you bring imbalance in homeostasis. Then you can get cold and many things, because the clothing help the temperature of the body and it help circulation. And therefore, we need to think when we dress that we can dress properly, that we can keep the circulation going and not obstruct the circulation. Okay? Mm-hmm. Rana?
We have a question. Somebody sent in a question. What would you recommend if a man has hepatitis C?
Pardon?
What would you recommend if a man has hepatitis C? Somebody sent in a question on the computer.
It have to do with the diet. And something very important, the liver. One of these organs that is very important that we help it to function properly. If we have our nutrition, good nutrition, and then the organs have to be functioning in a proper way so that he can bring balance in everything. And so one of those problem today, our nutrition also affect the whole chemistry of the body, and this bring this balance, and try always to bring homeostasis, and this the body will have the proper temperature, and with the proper temperature then he will produce all the chemicals that the body need. If the temperature of the body is too high or too low, then the process of the chemistry in the body will change and cause a lot of toxins that will affect all the vitamins, minerals, and everything, and affect all these health problems that we have today. We don't need to, for example, to know all the names of the sickness and the disease that have today. Just go back to the lifestyle, the 8 principles, and try to have a diet that will help us to bring balance in everything that we do, in every problem that we can have with health. And this is God's plan for us today. Simple methods. God will do great wonders with these simple methods that He has given us. Okay?